In this video, we are going to see how to apply mesh analysis for a problem where current source is given between two meshes. So here is the problem. In this problem, you have to get the I1, I2, I3 are the mesh currents marked like this. The speciality of this problem is a current source, a dependent current source, which depends upon the voltage. So we can say voltage controlled current source is given between two mesh, and we will see how to solve the problem. First of all, as per the mesh current which is flowing through a particular resistance will give rise to voltage drop in this manner. Now over here for 3 ohm, there are 2 voltage drops right now. So let's encircle the voltage drop given by them to distinguish their voltage and voltage developed by our mesh currents. So we'll have the voltages because of the current I2 in this manner. So if you see properly, for this 3 ohm, there are 3 voltage drops marked. 2 because of the I1 and I2 as per our mesh current, and 1 is given by them. So it's a very important information we can get out of it. We will see later on. I3 will develop the voltage drop across 2 resistors like this. So here we have marked voltage drop to each and every resistor present. So let's go for KVL. Now thing is that in the mesh 1, there is a current source, but it's not present alone in the mesh 1, it is between 2 meshes. Hence, we will hold on, we will not apply KVL to mesh 1 for time being. Let's go ahead to the mesh 2. Mesh 2 is a very safe because here we are not having such a condition where we cannot apply a KVL. Straight away, 3 resistors are given. So, we can apply KVL to mesh 2 first. Let's start from here, plus minus, so it's minus I2, minus plus, plus I3, plus minus, minus 2I2, plus minus. The polarity that developed because of the mesh current, I am focusing only on that polarity. So plus minus, minus 3 current is I2, and minus plus, plus 3 current is I1 equal to 0. So after simplifying, we will get a straightforward equation as 3I1 minus 6I2 plus I3 equal to 0 as equation number 1. A straightforward equation we get. Let's go ahead to the mesh 3, and we are lucky in the mesh 3 we are having a current source present only in that particular mesh, which will be helpful for us writing the equation as I3 equal to 15 as equation number 2. Okay, so here being the current source present in the loop 3, no need to apply KVL to that particular mesh, which is mesh 3 in this case. So, two equations we got straightforward. Let's tackle the issue of this current source. If you see properly this branch is carrying two currents. One is I1 in this direction, and second is I3 in this direction. And the given current direction is left to right, which is matching with the I1. So I can say this particular current source, which is nothing but a voltage controlled current source, can be written as I1 minus I3
equal to 0.111 Bx.
What we have done? Simply we have written the equation of this current source. So I can write here, it is an equation of current source which is present between two meshes. To solve the equations, we need one equation which we can get from here, but Vx is the variable which is not decided by us. We need to have a substitution for this. So, substitution equation will be Vx is nothing but voltage across this 3 ohm. And over here, we are having the three polarities as I mentioned earlier. The polarity given by them is matching with this polarity. And this polarity is developed because of the I1. So I can say Vx is nothing but resistor 3 multiplied by the polarity given by them is matching with the polarity that has been created by the I1. Hence, I1 is dominating over I2. So, 3 into I1 minus I2. So, we have substitution equation like this. If we substitute, we will get I1 minus I3 equal to 0.111. multiplied by 3 into I1 minus I2. So if we simplify, we will have I1 minus I3 equal to 0.333 I1 minus 0.333 I2, and further simplification will give us equation as 0.667 I1 plus 0.333 I2 minus I3 equal to 0 as the third equation. So we got three equations, we have three unknowns. That is what our answer. So after solving equation 1, 2 and 3, we will get I1 as 17 ampere, I2 as 11 ampere and I3 as 15 ampere. And this is the final answer. Thank you.